despicable, dishonorable, beneath contempt, deeply deceitful.
I want to talk about sore losers. There seem to be a lot of them nowadays, scattered all throughout MAGA. Because, you know, they're a bunch of losers.
That in a circumstance like this, I would be able to concede to a worthy opponent. But I do not have a worthy opponent to which I can concede.
This guy Dan Kelly in Wisconsin? What a piece of shit. My God, man. Step off the stage. Don't be a bitch about it. But that's what MAGA is. A pile of bitches. It's a bunch of damn snowflakes. They talk about how we melt down. My God, these people are weak.
This was the most deeply deceitful, dishonorable, despicable campaign I have ever seen run for the courts. It was truly beneath contempt.
You see?
Who is that?
You see, kids.
I thought that was a candidate.
Yeah, it is. So,
they're
kids,
supposed to be.
Here's the deal. If you want to have a future in politics or elected office, when you lose, I know what you've seen over the past 5, 6, 7 years, but when you lose, you are gracious.
They know it when they're going down. They can feel it. That's why it's such a fucking mad dash to destroy each other. So now, I want to talk about how badass my guy is.
Please welcome a son of Balana and the 46th President of the United States, Joe Biden.
All around the world, no matter where Joe goes, he's awesome. He's loved by all. He's gotten more done in the first 3 years than any president in American history. Created more jobs than anybody could have ever imagined.
Mary, I see the light. It's great to be back in Baltimore during your 300th anniversary.
I just received a beautiful letter from Kim Jong-un. I can't show you the letter, obviously, but it was a very personal, very warm, very nice letter. I appreciate it. And I'll say it again. I think that North Korea has tremendous potential. And the one that feels that more than anybody is Kim Jong-un. He gets it.
Republicans can talk about how shitty the economy is, but you're watching this video? If you're watching this video and you're actually doing worse now than you were before Joe Biden became president, leave me a comment. Tell me about how shitty your life is, because I would like to hear.
Now they'll say, Donald Trump said they fell in love. How horrible. How horrible is that? So unpresidential.
Sincerely, are there a lot of people that Joe Biden has hurt, or there are millions and millions and millions that Joe Biden has helped?
The narratives, whatever comes to your mind. Putin.
Well, I'm going to have to go a little short, but I got along with him great. Had I been president, he would have been much better off because he wouldn't have gone into Ukraine. but ultimately he's going to take over all of Ukraine.
Cheat.
A man I got along, again, I got along with him great until COVID came in. We would have been able to work together very much.
Kim Jong-un.
Again, got along with him great. People.
But Willie, right there, I mean, I hope that Dan Kelly felt good about himself after that speech, because nobody else felt good about him. Ended that way, and they never get elected again. Their career's over.
We'll never give up. We will never concede. It doesn't happen. You don't concede when there's theft involved. Our country has had enough. We will not take it anymore, and that's what this is all about.
President Xi is a brilliant man. If you went all over Hollywood to look for somebody to play the role of President Xi, you couldn't find him. There's nobody like that. The look, the brain, the whole thing. We had a great relationship.
Yeah, he went on to say, Wisconsin voted for what he called the rule of Janet, but that's their choice to make, he said. That's former Wisconsin State Supreme Court Justice Dan Kelly. That was his concession speech last night, and it was Janet Protasiewicz who defeated the conservative in the most expensive state Supreme Court race in American history, giving liberals control of Wisconsin's high court for the first time in 15 years.
This is why they're such sore losers. Because they know it's over. There's not going to be another election for these guys. It's over. I'm Zachariah, Lone Star Liberal. Y'all take it easy.